Hello students, welcome to video classes. So in the last class we have discussed about the loss or gain of the time due to the reason of the linear expansion in the pendulum clocks. And the concept is very important for the competitive part also. I hope all of you remember the formulas. Okay, what is the formula to find out the loss or gain of the time? The formula is delta t is equals to half into alpha into delta t. Delta capital T represents the change in time. Small t represents temperature. Half into alpha into delta t. This is the change in time in 1 second. If I find out in 1 day into what happened 86,400. Okay, then it will be the change in time per one complete day will be takes place. Okay, this is the concept. After that we are discussed about the bimetallic strip. Okay, bimetallic strip is the combination of the two different metals of different alpha values. Okay, when they are going to be heated based on the expansion of the metals, sometimes they are going to be bent in the form of a convex and sometimes they are going to bend in the form of a concave shape. So there is a like real life applications are also there which I have discussed in the last classes. Okay, and today we are going to discuss the two more concepts. Okay, out of them the first one is called, we are going to find out a condition to keep the difference between the two metal rods will be constant at all the temperatures. Then what is the condition should be required? Okay, for example, I am going to take the two metal rods here. Let us say that this is the metal rod A and this is the metal rod B. Okay, the metal rod A and metal rod B. And what is the condition is here? Alpha A is greater than alpha B. Alpha A is greater than alpha B. That means what happens here, both the metal rods are made with the different materials. At the same time, the alpha values are not constant. The alpha value of A is maximum, alpha value of B is minimum. So what does that mean? If you are giving the same amount of heat energy, for example, if you are going to increase the temperature of this one 50 degrees Celsius, and again you are going to increase the temperature of 50 degrees Celsius, both does not expand same. It will be expands more and it will be expands less. On that condition, what happened? The difference between the two metal rods, okay, the difference between the two metal rods will not be constant. But if you want to keep them constant, that means whatever the temperature you may increase, okay, either 20 degrees Celsius or the 40 degrees Celsius or 100 degrees Celsius or 500 degrees Celsius, if you want to keep the difference between the two metal rods is constant, then there is a condition should be satisfied. And that condition is L1 alpha 1 is equals to L2 alpha 2. L1 alpha 1 is equals to L2 alpha 2. Alpha 1 belongs to A and alpha 2 belongs to B. L1 belongs to A and L2 belongs to B. That means L1 is the initial length of the A and L2 is the initial length of the B. Alpha 1 coefficient of linear expansion of A and alpha 2 coefficient of linear expansion of B. That means if this condition is satisfied, then what happened? Whatever the temperature you may change, always what happened? The difference between the two metal rods will be remain same. For example, this is L1 is equals to, for example, you are saying that this is 5 meters. And L2 is equals to how much it will be? 6 meters. L1 is 5 meters and L2 is 6 meters. Okay, you are taking at the room temperature. At the room temperature, what is the difference between the two metal rods? The difference between the two metal rods is 6 minus 5. That is equals how much the change is there? Delta L is equals to 1 meter. After that, what happens? You are increasing the temperature 30 degrees centigrade, you are increased. From the room temperature, you are increasing the temperature up to 30 degrees centigrade, you are increased. Then also what happened? The difference between the two metal rods will be 1 meter. Actually, what should happen? These alpha values are different, differently expands. Even though what happened, the difference between the two metal rods is constant 1 meter. After that, you are increased the 50 degrees Celsius. Temperature 50 degrees Celsius, temperature you are increased. On that condition also, the difference will be 1 meter. 100 degrees Celsius you are increased. On that condition also, the difference between the two metal rods is 1 meter. Why it is happening? The reason is these two metal rods are satisfying the condition L1 alpha 1 is equals to L2 alpha 2. If this condition is satisfied, then automatically what happened, whatever the temperature may increase, the difference between the two metal rods will be remains constant, which is very, very important concept for the competitive part, even for PU also. Okay, L1 alpha 1 is equals to L2 alpha 2. can tell you what is the relation, how they are related. The length is inversely proportional to the linear expansion. Okay, the length is inversely proportional to linear expansion. Because alpha 1 is there here, alpha 2 is coming to denominator. L2 is there, L1 is going to denominator. That means what you can write? Alpha 1 by alpha 2 is equals to L2 by L1. That means if the coefficient of linear expansion and the initial length of the two dots are inversely proportional, then what happened? Whatever the temperature we may increase, always what happened? The difference between the two metal rods will be remains constant. Okay, not only this length, any type of the metal you may take. If the two different types of the metals you are having and they are satisfying this condition, then always you are going to get the constant difference of the lengths you are going to be takes place. Okay, try to remember the condition. L1 alpha 1 is equals to L2 alpha 2, which is very important to solve the problems. Next, our next concept is also very important, which is called the thermal stress. Okay, our next concept is called the thermal stress. So this thermal stress, before we discuss about this thermal stress, first we are going to discuss about the stress. Stress means nothing but the pressure we are going to be applying. Okay, stress means nothing but pressure. Actually, about this concept, again we are going to discuss at the time of the elastic nature or elasticity, mechanical properties of solids chapter. Okay, because this concept is related with the topic. So just now I am going to briefly explaining what are the concepts. About these concepts, very deeply we can discuss at the time of the mechanical properties of the solids itself. Okay, stress. First, nothing but the stress is nothing but it is a pressure. I think all of you know the pressure formula. What is the pressure formula? The pressure P is equals to F by A. The pressure P is equals to F by A. P is the pressure, or you can call it as a stress. F is the force and A is the area of cross section. How can I define it? The force applied per unit area. Okay, the force applied per unit area will be called as a pressure, or you can call it as a stress. Okay. Now, by seeing this formula, can you tell me the units? The force is measured in newtons and area is measured in meter square. Newton per meter square. What is the other unit of pressure? The other unit of pressure is measured in Pascal. Okay, it will be measured in Pascal. Okay. So, Newton per meter square or Pascal. This is the pressure or the stress. Okay, units itself. Okay, what is the stress means? The force applied per unit area will be called as a stress. Next one, we are going to discuss about the thermal stress. To understand this, I am going to explain the diagram here. All of you must concentrate on the diagram. So earlier classes we already discussed that if you are going to give the heat energy to any substance, then what happens? The size of the object is going to be increases, or it is going to be expands. If you are going to decrease the temperature, contraction will be takes place. So basically remember that concept and concentrate on the diagram part here. So what I am doing is I am just going to take a metal bar here. This is a metal bar I am taking. Okay, this is a metal bar. And I am going to take the two rigid supports. This metal bar I am going to be fixed between the two rigid supports. Okay, this is one rigid support and this is another rigid support. Okay, this metal bar is going to be fixed between the two rigid supports. I am fixed very tightly in between the two rigid supports. After that, I am started heating it. Okay, I am giving the heat energy. When I am going to heat this metal bar, then what happens? This metal bar will try to expand. Okay, this metal bar will try to expand. But is it possible to expand by this metal bar? No. What is the reason? The reason is this metal bar is supported by this rigid supports. Okay, they are fixed between the two rigid supports. That's why these rigid supports will not allow the metal bar to expand. But we are giving the heat energy. So by taking the heat energy, what happened? It will try to expand, but the rigid supports are not allowing to expand. Due to that reason, what happened? There is some stress will be developed inside the metal bar. Metal bar not try to expand, but these are not allowing. That's why what happened? Inside the metal bar, some stress will be developed, which is called the thermal stress. Okay? So that is called the thermal stress. So when this thermal stress will be exhibited? When the metal bar will try to expand and the expansion is not possible, on that condition what happened? The thermal stress will be takes place. In another way, without giving the heat energy, you are just decreasing the temperature.
If you are going to decrease the temperature of this metal bar, then what happened? Contraction will take place. If you are giving the heat energy, expansion. If you are decreasing the temperature, what happened? Contraction will be takes place. And these rigid supports are not allowing for contraction also, because you are fixed them at here and you are fixed at here. Due to that reason, what happened? This rigid supports does not allow for contraction also. But you are decreasing the temperature. Metal bar wants to contract, but the rigid supports are not allowing. In this condition, again, what happened? The thermal stress will be developed. That means the thermal stress will develop not only when you are increasing the temperature, while you are decreasing the temperature also, thermal stress will be takes place. Because here, these rigid supports are both are not allowing for both. They are not allowing for expansion and they are not allowing for the contraction also. So that's why in both cases what happened, the thermal stress is going to be takes place. Okay, this is the reason why we are going to have the thermal stress. The same concept again we are going to use at the time of elasticity chapter. Okay, so if I find out how much thermal stress is developed inside the metal bar, then the formula is the thermal stress is F by A is equals to, thermal stress F by A is equals to, what you can write the formula is Y into alpha into delta T. Okay, the thermal stress F by A is equals to Y into alpha into delta T. Here one new term is there, this is Young's modulus. About this Young's modulus we can discuss at the time of elastic nature of the material or mechanical properties of solids. At the time of the chapter we can discuss about this Young's modulus. What is this Young's modulus? This Young's modulus will explain about the stability of the material. That means if more Young's modulus, more stability. Less Young's modulus, less stability. So that's why this is the Young's modulus we are going to be having. Because the stress will develop and how much stress is developing more or less, that will be depends on the strength of that material. If the strength of the material is more, then the stress is also more. Strength of the material is less, then the stress is also very less itself. So Y represents Young's modulus. Try to remember the term. About this Young's modulus deeply we can discuss at the time of mechanical properties of solids. And alpha, coefficient of linear expansion, you know this. And delta T represents temperature change or change in temperature. In this way you can find out the thermal stress developed here. F by A is equals to Y into alpha into delta T. And what are the units here? Newton per meter square. The units are very, very important. Okay? Y into alpha into delta T, Newton per meter square. Sometimes in the examination what happened, he will ask about the thermal force. Okay? He is not going to ask thermal stress, he will ask the thermal force. From this formula, what is the thermal force means? This F value. Okay? This F will represent thermal force. That means if you want to find out the thermal force, then what happened to the formula? The thermal force F is equals to. So it becomes Y into alpha into delta T into A. That means this thermal stress is going to multiply. A is going to numerator to multiply it. Then you are going to get the thermal force. Y into alpha into delta T into A. Y is the Young's modulus. Alpha, constant of linear expansion. Delta T, change in temperature. And A represents area of cross-section. Area of cross-section of the metal bar. So it will clearly express that if area of cross-section is more, then the thermal stress is also more. Thermal force is also more itself. And can you tell me what are the units will be? The units are newtons. Okay, the units are newtons. So F is equals to Y into alpha into delta T into A. This is the thermal stress concept itself. Okay, these are the concepts which are there in the case of the expansion of the solids. And what are the concepts we have discussed, all of you must remember. In the next class, we are going to solve the problems. If you want to solve the problems, definitely you need to remember all the formulas, whatever we have discussed up to right now. So, today all of you practice or revise the concept. I hope all of you are making the notes of these topics. And whenever you are getting the formulas, please make a note of the formulas and revise them. So, tomorrow we are going to solve the problems. All of you must revise all the concepts, whatever we have discussed up to this topic in the expansion of the solids, and come for the class tomorrow. Okay, tomorrow we are going to solve the problems. Okay? That's all for today. See you in the next class. Thank you.